second pick, so I think we can, it's safe to go ahead and try out a first edition of a mock draft now. And of course, a lot of these will change over the course of the next couple months with the NFL Combine and all of that still to come, so expect a few editions of these mock draft videos. And I'm not going to go too in-depth or really in-depth at all for some of these picks. We have to go through 32 teams, so I expect this to be a pretty long video as is without any explanation, so I don't really want this to be an hour-long video or anything. So, without further ado, we will open our trusty notebook to a fresh page and get started with our very first mock draft. Also, not going to be projecting any trades in this mock draft except for one, which is the Bears trading out of the first overall pick, which I'm pretty confident that they're going to do with either the Texans, Colts, Panthers, or Raiders, one of those QB needy teams in the top 10. But that's the only draft trade that I'm going to project for now. I just think it's pretty impossible to guess the mid-round trades, so. With the first overall pick, I have the Houston Texans trading up from number 2 with the Bears. Again, I think this could be any of 4 teams trading up to this number 1 pick. The Bears don't really need a quarterback, so I think they'll definitely trade out of number 1. And with the number 1 pick, I have the Texans picking Bryce Young, quarterback out of Alabama. I think this is a pretty obvious pick here. They're definitely going with a quarterback. And I think Young, well, maybe it's not that obvious. I think Young and CJ Stroud both have a case to be the first quarterback off the board. But I don't think Will Levis or Anthony Richardson deserve to be the first quarterback off the board here. So I'm going to go with Young, but I could also see this being Stroud. So that means the Bears have the number 2 pick. I could also see them trading out of this spot, but I'm just going to leave them at number 2 for the sake of simplicity in this mock. And I will have them take Jalen Carter, defensive tackle from Georgia. The Bears have quite a few holes, and, Carter's just going to be an elite player on that line, so I think they'll shore up that position there with the best player available. Number 3 is the Arizona Cardinals. And I have them taking Will Anderson, edge from Alabama. Edge basically meaning defensive end. seen a lot of mocks where Will Levis goes to the Colts. I just think that would be a big mistake by the Colts or any team in the top 10, really. I don't think Levis is going to be all that good of a quarterback, but... Pick number 5 is the Seahawks. And I have them taking Tyree Wilson, edge from Texas Tech. The 6th pick is the Detroit Lions. And I have them taking Devon Witherspoon, quarterback from Illinois. Seven, the Raiders are selecting Will Levis in my mock draft. Someone I'm not too high on, but seems to be a consensus top 10 pick. Taking Brian Branch, safety from Alabama. At 11, I have the Titans taking Peter Skoronski, offensive tackle from Northwestern. Johnson Jr. He is an offensive tackle from Ohio State. At 14, I have the Patriots taking Jackson Smith and Jigba. Wide receiver from Ohio State. I think Njigba might go a little bit further back in the first round, but I want the Patriots to take him. As a Patriots fan, I think he might be the best receiver in the draft, so I'd like the Patriots to take him here, but I'm not sure that they will. Taking Michael Meyer, tight end out of Notre Dame. 16, I have the Commanders taking Joey Porter Jr., cornerback out of Penn State. Got ahead of myself there. At 17, I think the Steelers take Broderick Jones, offensive tackle from Georgia. Their offensive line was pretty terrible this year, and Najee Harris could use some better linemen to run behind, as well as Kenny Pickett getting some more time in the pocket. At 20, I have the Seahawks taking Kelee Ringo, cornerback from Georgia. And the Dolphins were supposed to have the 21st pick, but it has been forfeited because they violated some league rules a little while back, so the Dolphins forfeit this pick, so we'll move on to 22. At 22, I have the Chargers taking Jordan Addison, wide receiver from USC. They need another player to kind of stretch the field for them, and I've also recently heard rumors that Keenan Allen might be a cap, or a player they might cut to save some cap room, so I think the Chargers definitely take a wide receiver here. I have the Vikings taking Kalijah Kancey, defensive tackle out of Pittsburgh. At 25, I have the Jaguars taking Darnell Washington, tight end out of Georgia. I think there's a decent chance Evan Engram leaves due to his big career year this year with Jacksonville, so they'll be in need of a tight end. I have the Giants taking Zay Flowers at 26, wide receiver out of Boston College. I think everyone expects the Giants to take a receiver here with the multitude of problems they have at that position. At 27, I have the Cowboys taking wide receiver Jalen Hyatt out of Tennessee. Outside of CeeDee Lamb and Dalton Schultz, their receiving options are pretty thin. this. The Bills running game was pretty weak with Devin Singletary leading it. James Cook was a decent back, especially on the receiving side, but Bijan Robinson, I think, is a special running back prospect out of Texas, and he would really elevate that offense even further to where they'd be very dominant. At 29, I have the Bengals taking Luke Musgrave, tight end, out of Oregon State. At 30 are the New Orleans Saints due to the Sean Payton trade with the Broncos, and I have them taking Osiris Torrance, offensive guard from Florida. And I just put the Chiefs at 31 and the Eagles at 32. I'm not gonna spoil my Super Bowl pick in this video here, but I just kind of did that because all the other mock drafts I've seen online have done that, maybe just because it's alphabetical order. But at 31, the Chiefs select Lucas Van Ness, edge from Iowa. Finally, at 32, we have the Eagles picking Jahmyr Gibbs, running back from Alabama. With Miles Sanders being a free agent this year, they could use a new running back. I've seen a lot of mocks having them take Bijan Robinson, and I think if the Bills don't pick Bijan, I think the Eagles will. He's more of a third or three down back than Gibbs is, but I have them taking a running back regardless, so. And those are all 32 picks in the first round for my mock draft 1.0. Let me know what you think of your team's pick in the first round and who you want your team to pick in the first round of this year's draft. Of course, as I said, it's still pretty early days here. The combine hasn't even happened yet, and there'll be a lot of switching around after the combine happens. So I'll probably make my mock draft 2.0 after the combine, and then maybe a third one a couple days before the draft, but this is what I've come up with so far. Let me know your thoughts. And with that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and I will see you next time.